Einen wunderschönen guten Tag. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Hello, aliens. Hello, humans. Welcome at Seabase Space Station. For those of you which are here the first time, the Seabase is a club where we reconstruct a crashed space station, which is crashed here on planet Earth. And it comes from the far future. So what we actually do is we do future research in all kinds of science and culture. And so we're trying to find out what comes next. And therefore, we also looking for mobile devices. And a part of our projects here is the Seabase Mobile Interfaces project. And there we do software development and a lot of talks. And one series of events we started here is the MIGO Free Day, and this is what you actually attend to. This is the MIGO Free Day, and today we will have some interesting talks, but what this exactly means will UK explain soon to you. And after the event, the doors will be still open. And for those of you which are interested in getting more knowledge about the Seabase and what we're actually doing here, there will be a guided tour, something around 10 o'clock, maybe a bit earlier. But this will be announced separately. So thank you very much for attending here. And I hand over to UK, who will tell you what you will get here today.
Hello. This is Tee from Seabase. My name is Philip Minson. Somebody will know me the pseudonym UK or UK. And okay, I hope everybody can hear me now. Yes, today Intel are our guests here at the space station, and Paul from the AppUp developer program will talk to us and give an introduction about the AppUp developer program. He will tell us something about the AppUp store and tell how what you have to do to prepare your application.
It's interesting.
And how you can submit your application to the AppUp store, and what kind of mechanism is there for validation, and what opportunities do you have to promote your application and stuff like this. Then we will have a short break, or it's not so short, but we have to, I think we can eat some pizza, stuff like this, for 45 minutes. And in the second presentation, we will get information about MIGO development tools from Intel. Yeah, and Paul will tell us how you can tune or tune your application, how you can get it working faster and better with MIGO. Yes, and then we will have another break and can network. Do some networking stuff and discussions, and I think our experts will be available for your questions and stuff like this. And then we will have the Seabase presentation. Follow this guy at 10 o'clock. It's very nice, and yeah. So welcome to this event, and yeah. My name is Uwe from meetmigo.org, and have a nice time.
Thank you. I forgot to tell you, it's not only on the space station today. We have some technology used to stream this event live to planet Earth. So it's actually possible to see it on the internet. At seabase.org, you can see the things which are happening here in audio and in optical pictures. You maybe heard of that. And if you can tell your friends here's something going on which is interesting, send them a link to the video stream so they can join us. It's not teleportation, but it's something like that. Yeah, thank you for spreading the message. And now, Paul.
Hello. Thank you. Hello, everyone. Hello, everyone online as well. Welcome to Berlin. Thank you for having us here. We're very, very glad to be here at the CBase today. Thanks, CBase. And I also extend my thanks to Cosimo, who's been organizing many things for us. There he is in the background. Give him a big hand. Thanks, Cosimo. And all the people online who can't see the crowd, this room goes back another 5 kilometers and the room is packed. We've got plenty of people here and they all want to hear what Intel has to say about developing for MeeGo and the Intel AppUp developer program. We have some small text here, legal disclaimer. I am obliged to explain this to you, so please fasten your seatbelts. It's going to take a while. No, we're not going to do this. Optimization notice, we are also required to show this to you. There were some issues and we are taking care of this properly and showing the optimization notice. This brings us to this evening's agenda. We are already in the introduction, the first point of this list, then we're going to follow where I tell you about the Intel AppUp developer program, how you can create program MeeGo applications for AppUp. And I'll also tell you what AppUp is. I'll also explain how to submit applications and to get them validated for the store. Then we'll have a short break, 45 minutes roughly, and there'll be some pizza, and I hope we all manage to eat it. Well, we've got, yeah, there's plenty of people. We'll manage. And after the break, I'll explain how to tune your applications with tools we give to you, to the MeeGo community to develop and optimize programs for MeeGo. Then it says here, pick your device. Many of you have received some pieces of paper where we've asked you to put your signature on. We're going to give you some presents to take away with you today. Did you see those ducks when you came in? It's the adopt the duck evening, so everyone gets a duck. When you go out, queue up and you will get a duck. There's plenty of there. And alongside the ducks, you get also a tablet. I know there's one tablet in this room. Tillman's got a tablet. Hold it up. That's it. That's what these people are going to get today, pre-installed with MeeGo. I think the build is not up to date. You might want to update the MeeGo build when you get home, but you're going to walk away with that today. And before I start to bore you, I'm going to present you to Monica.
Thank you for the welcome. I'm the community manager for the Intel AppUp developer program. Started out at Intel at March 1st. And these are some pictures, so you get some personal insights of me. On the left, it depends. You can see myself in a kimono. This is because I'm half Japanese. Other things is my hometown is Mannheim, which is not necessarily the prettiest town in Germany, but you cannot choose where you were born and grew up. I moved to Munich as soon as I could. I'm still living there. I lived for 1 year in Tokyo. This is why I chose this kind of pictures. And I also managed to, I got really stuffed into one of the trains, which wasn't really funny, but it helped me to get back home, so I was fine. The companies I mentioned, I started out my career at Fujitsu Siemens in different positions in marketing, culture change management. Then I worked at Microsoft for 1.5 year, first as community engagement manager, and then as media intelligence manager. I'm within PR, and now I'm at Intel. I'm taking care of developer relationships. And here's some information about our social media channels. So if you want to tweet about us or about this evening, it would be great if you could include the hashtags AppUp or developforAppUp. You can find our official Twitter handle at develop for AppUp EU, where you can get more formal information about the program, what Intel is doing on a EMEA-wide level. Monica_AppUp, this is my personal Twitter handle, which is kind of a mixture of open source. It's sometimes I'm also still mentioning Microsoft stuff, and what I'm doing and what I'm up to, so it's a mixture of all of this. If you want to follow all of us, like Paul is also on Twitter, you can also just follow the list. All of our team members are on it. Our Facebook pages, first of all, we have a Facebook page for Intel Germany, and we have a dedicated one also for Developer AppUp, which is in English and gives out information on a global level. And the rest is just the websites to get more information about AppUp. And back to Paul.
Thank you. Some information about myself. I come from Scotland, and in Scotland we like to eat and drink. We drink stuff like this. We'll participate in games where we do throwing things around and tossing things. So we enjoy that very much. And what I like doing is I like building computers out of bits and pieces and putting them together and playing games with them. And I like gadgets. It's a small collection of stuff that I've got in my drawer at home. So lots of smartphones and mobile phones and things. You might know some of these. And you've got my Twitter account if you want to follow me directly. Which brings us to the start of today's program. If anyone has a question, doesn't matter what you want to ask, please interrupt me immediately and ask the question. It doesn't hurt to ask a question. If you want, if you're more comfortable, ask me in German. Ich spreche auch Deutsch, ist gar kein Problem. Also wir können auch uns auch in Deutsch unterhalten. But if you want to speak English, so the Earthlings following us on this ancient internet stream, they will be able to understand what we are talking about. Okay. The Intel AppUp Developer Program and the Intel AppUp Center. Now, what is this all about? Last year at CES, Intel announced they're going to do an application store called AppUp. And around the store, to attract and support developers, we're going to initiate a program called the Intel AppUp Developer Program. So this is the store web front website, and this is the developer program website. So this is the important bit for all developers, and this is where the customers go to online to look for applications. Initially, when we announced this, we said we're going to do this for Windows. And in Barcelona this year, the MWC, we announced we're doing it for Migo. How far have we got so far on the Windows side is, we've got some figures here. We've got about 3,200 applications there, 21,000 registered members to the program. That's developers. So that's not users, that's developers. Registered, 21,000 developers participating in the program. It says 15 stores here, 15 AppUp powered stores. I'll tell you why it's not one, it's 15. I'll tell you about that in a few moments. It says two operating systems, Windows and Migo, obviously. As I said, we started with Windows and we focus on netbooks. Now, why did Intel choose to focus on netbooks? Excuse me? And why with Windows? Yes. Well, at the time, Migo was even further away than some people think it is today. And Windows was obvious, an obvious choice. But why netbooks? Netbooks because when you buy a netbook, there's no CD-ROM in it. And there's hardly any software attached to it. And we found out by talking to our customers and partners like retailers, like Dixon's and people like that, and Best Buy and Walmart, the majority of netbooks are bought by women, mothers, who buy them for the children. Okay, so this mother goes to Walmart, buys a netbook for her daughter, for her son, credit card, buys it, brings it home. Here you go, daughter, here's your netbook, have fun, enjoy the games. Mommy, there's no games on this. Of course not, because nothing's installed. There's no CD-ROM. Difficult problem. So how does mother solve this problem? Well, we've told her, don't download software from the internet. That's evil. Don't do it. And don't use your credit card on the internet to buy anything, because you'll get ripped off and your house will be burnt down and everything will happen and everything will go completely wrong. So don't do this. So how does she get software into her netbook? Well, she's just been to Walmart with a credit card and bought the netbook with a credit card. And she comes home and opens up the netbook, and it says here, Walmart's application store, powered by Intel. And so she's just used the credit card at Walmart, so she'll use it again at the Walmart store on a netbook. So that's the motivation to do this. And it works quite well, so we get quite a lot of number of downloads from these customers. A number of retailers said, well, if you're doing netbooks, you might as well do notebooks. So we said, okay, let's do notebooks. So on the Windows side, we're also supporting notebooks today. But we require that an application submitted for Windows must run on a netbook. So that's the common lowest denominator of all applications, a netbook. These are the environments and languages we support together today. You see here, Java.NET, Adobe Air, obvious choices for Windows, not really for Migo. On the Migo side, Qt, yes, definitely. And World Wide Web, maybe not so obvious. We have just launched a beta program. It's an online service called the Web Encapsulator, where web developers can submit a web application to this service, and it will crank the handle, and out will come two applications, a Migo application and a Windows application, out of your web application. So it turns your web application into a native application that will run on Windows or on Migo. It's a cost-free service. You can try it out. So for Windows, we have these languages here, and for Migo, we have C++, Qt, and World Wide Web available today as tools for or runtimes for developers. As I said, at MWC Barcelona, there were many announcements. One was Intel's supporting Migo heavily, and we're bringing the application store app to Migo. Migo is a massively growing ecosystem. There's been couple of announcements in the press this week. Cosimo has been twittering about LG joining Migo and developing devices for Migo. Cosimo, you twittered something about that. And we've put a picture on here. It's a snapshot. It's already old, although we did this in February. So you see a number of OSVs, system integrators, silicon vendors, AMDs here as well, service providers. So these are telcos that have agreed to do Migo, like Orange, Sprint, Telefonica, Telecom Italia, OEMs, Acer, Asus, Nokia, Gemtek. So these are OEMs who have, we would have to add LG here obviously now, who have committed to do Migo devices and Migo support. And then we have a large number of ISVs, software development houses, who are developing software for Migo. What we don't have on this page is car companies. Not a lot of people know this. There's a consortium called GenIVI, a group of car manufacturers who got together and said, we need a common operating system for the in-car entertainment. So until now, everyone's done his own thing and nothing's compatible to each other, and it's a big pain for them. So they said, okay, we'll do something based on an open source solution, and they chose Migo as the base operating system for in-car entertainment. So all these companies are developing, are committed to do Migo in their cars. And there's a lot of members of Genevieve. You can all look this up on the website. So you find companies like NVIDIA, Bosch, ST, Renesas, TomTom, Alpine, Continental, lots of big companies who are committed to do MIGO development for cars. So MIGO in cars is going to be a big thing in the next few years. There is already one car running with MIGO, Chinese car, that's using MIGO for its in-car entertainment system today already. So that's already on the market. Yes?
Do we talk about core features of cars?
Core what?
Core features, you know, reacts in kind of accidents or something like that. You know, what making really what makes the car drive, or do we talk about all the entertainment stuff? And, you know. So there's a
that's a long question.
There's
you get
there's
to
a common there's an known an known thing where
okay.
people
okay.
hack the car by MP3.
Okay.
So I don't think it's a good idea to take a web OS
okay.
for driven a car.
Okay. Now as I said, it's GenIVI. I'll just go back to that slide. GenIVI. IVI means in-car vehicle entertainment, whatever. So it's about entertainment. So it's all about audio, video, internet services based around that. So it's nothing mission critical in the car. So there's no safety and no engine controls, nothing like that involved. So if the thing should crash, you wouldn't be able to listen to RIAs or your favorite CD or MP3s, but you can still drive your car. You may have noticed that I gave the gentleman something, a little reward for his question. So people ask, questions get fed. We have different things to choose from, and I'll ask Monica to assist me here and to help this sharing out the cookies, or the goodies, sorry about that, no cookies. Yes, so we had a chat about cars in vehicle entertainment. These are the other devices that ecosystems that MIGO is supporting. Well, we have obviously netbooks and things like that. We have the obvious handhelds and smartphones where we're going to bring MIGO towards to. Tablets, big thing. There's a lot of tablet developments happening at the moment, and we'll see tablets with MIGO coming out later this year. Netbooks we've already seen. I don't know if anyone got the press releases at Barcelona. They're already MIGO netbooks shipping from Fujitsu. I think Acer or Asus are also shipping. So you can buy actually netbooks with MIGO installed today. Tablets coming later on this year. Handhelds, we'll probably see handhelds with Intel Atom CPUs this year. And connected TV, you might know this, or you might not. There are already two set-top boxes in the market today, one in France and one in Italy, with MIGO operating system that's being sold in huge volumes with MIGO. So MIGO is all over the place, very interesting operating system. It's not a nerdy thing. It's really an operating system out in the live in industry. It's being used. Intel support is obviously silicon. That's where it starts. Intel is a silicon company. What we do is we take buckets of sand and convert it to money. And we do that very well. I think we're best in class at doing this. And we want to continue to do this and do more of this buckets to money thing. And we want to enter the mobile space. Intel and mobile, we don't have a massive market share yet. We're working towards to increase this enormous market share by make it even more enormous. But we found out just selling silicon in the mobile space is not what our customers are looking for. It works in the Windows and the PC in the server space, but not really in the mobile space. We need to provide customers a vertical stack, a stack of an ecosystem. So we said MIGO is going to be our choice of operating system for mobile environment. And to go along with MIGO, we're going to bring AppUp, the application store. So we're going to give our customer who wants to build a netbook, a TV, a smartphone, something for his car or a tablet, a complete solution package consisting of silicon, operating system, and the store. You can choose to take all of it or just one of it. We don't force them to take all three, but we'd like, obviously, if our customer chooses Migo and our store. This is the model that we're offering. Yes? Well, as I said, this is our core business, selling silicon. So it's important for us that the customer, our customer, takes our silicon, yes.
So I can choose another processor and take an Migo operating system and store from you.
Okay. You could take Migo. So you could exchange the CPU to any other CPU and put Migo on it, because Migo is open source. It's not controlled by Intel, it's not controlled by anyone. But the store is only available on Intel platform. There is no plan to go to a different platform today. Uh-huh. I'm being asked to exchange some of this technology. Okay. Are you happy? He looks happy. Good. So this is the business model that we're proposing to our customers. Customer builds devices, a whole range of devices he can put together here. I think I should move that quick. And through the AppUp store that we power, our customer can have his own branded storefront. Our customers being OEMs who build devices, service providers, that would be our classical telcos, retailers, places where people buy devices like Dixon's, Walmart, or partner marketplaces. So different storefronts where people see applications, all powered by the same service system in the background. This is the interesting thing for you as developers. By building on these common blocks, developer frameworks, building your applications for the App Store, you reach users in a different number of application stores. Stores branded as Intel Store, stores branded for service providers, ISVs, all different types of stores, co-branded stores. Yes? Yes? Yes?
The question was if you're talking to German retailers like MediaMarkt, Lidl, Aldi, Medion or something. Thank you.
We haven't launched the store in Germany yet. We're going to launch it. And during this process, we will speak to these people, to these types of retailers, but there's been no agreement settled so far. Okay? We did so in, I'll show you what we've done in other countries, and we'll do the similar thing in Germany and other parts of Europe as well. This is the business model. Here we've got you people, the developers, scratching their heads. You build your application, the greatest on the planet, put it into the application store. The consumer, this is the our mothers that we described earlier in the scenario, who's just been to Walmart with a credit card, find your application, buy it. If it's a paid application, of course, you can also submit free applications. It doesn't have to be paid. If it's paid application, she pays this. 70% of the money that our consumer gives into the store goes to the developer. And 30% goes to Intel. And out of this 30%, we pay our partners who have branded the store. So this could be our retailers or a telco or somebody else. And we also cover the operating costs and the validation costs and all these things for these applications out of these 30%. If you read the text, I think you're all capable of reading English, although it's an ancient language. It says here up to 70%. It says so because of tax reasons. Intel is a US company, and we are required to hold back taxes, tax withholding, for purchases or monies that we pay to you. There are methods to get out of this tax if your country has a tax treaty with the US. There are some details on our website how to do that, and there's more on the IRS website. It's not too difficult. But it's a common thing to most US-based companies when you have a business relationship and you want to get money out of that. But 70% is what you can get. As I said, partners with retailers, this is what we've done in countries where we've already launched this store, mainly the US, UK, India. We have partners like Dixon's Curries. So if you've ever been to the to UK, to England or Scotland. Who's been to Scotland anyway? Any Scottish fans here? One, two? Oh, you're missing out, you're missing out. You really need to go to Scotland. Did I tell you that you need to go to Scotland? Okay. Curry's and Dixon's, massive retailer, I think Europe's biggest retailer for electronics and stuff in EMEA, in Europe. And then in US, we've got CompUSA, Best Buy. Then we have people like Samsung, Fujitsu, who have the store pre-installed on their devices that they're selling out. So these people have stores with their own brand, their own name on the store, and it says powered by Intel. So you as a developer submit your application once to Intel, and we farm it out to all these stores at the same time. So you reach a number of stores but from one submission. Okay? I'll have to give you this microphone so that people online also